Hey everyone, welcome to part one of this 12-part Python tutorial series for beginners. In this chapter, you're going to learn how to install Python, install VS Code, and then use it to write and run your first Python application. Python is available on all platforms, including Windows, Mac, and Linux. Whichever of these systems you have, you should be able to follow along with these tutorials just fine. To download Python, go to python.org and then click on the Downloads tab. And from there, you can just follow the instructions for your specific platform. When using the Python installer for Windows, make sure that you check the button to add Python to your path. This will make it so that when you use Python from your terminal or your command line, you can directly use Python by just typing the name of the program. If you're using Mac or Linux, your computer should already come with Python installed. To check the version of Python that you've installed, open up the terminal program on your computer. On my Mac, I use iTerm2 as my terminal program. On Windows, you can use PowerShell as well. And don't worry if your terminal looks different to mine. They should more or less all work the same. So in your terminal prompt, type python --version. And then if you hit enter and run that, if Python's installed correctly, it should print out the Python version you have. So you can see here, -3.10. But if that doesn't work for you, if there's an error saying that there's no program called Python, or if you try that and you get a version 2 Python instead, and that's too old, you can try instead typing python 3--version. And then if you run that, it should work. If it doesn't work, then go back to the previous installation step and make sure that you have at least version 3.6. And if you have trouble doing that, then check the video descriptions for links that might be helpful or leave a question in the comments. So now that Python's installed, let's play around with it a little bit by running the Python interpreter. So go back to your terminal and then type Python, this time without the version. And if you use Python 3, then type Python 3. But for me, I'm just going to type Python. And when you run that, you should kind of see a new prompt. You're now inside the Python interpreter. So this is the Python interpreter, and you could sort of use it like an advanced calculator. So let's try something by typing maybe like 3 + 5. And then if you type that, you get the result, which is 8. You could also do multiplication, like 7 × 10. And then you get 70. You could also use it to store values inside a variable. So for example, I'm going to do x equals hello. Then I can print x to see which value I have stored in there. And you should see hello print out. So this is one way to run Python and one way to interact with Python directly. But for the rest of this tutorial, we're actually going to write our Python code into a file and then have the Python interpreter run that entire file for us top to bottom. It kind of does the same thing behind the scenes, but you won't be interacting with the interpreter directly. Once you're done with the interpreter, you can exit it by typing either exit and then open close parentheses, or hit Control D and that will exit you out of the terminal. Before we get coding, it's important to understand how the Python interpreter works. You can think of it as a translator, which translates human readable language, Python scripts, into machine instructions. And these instructions will tell your computer what to do, whether that's adding numbers together, trading stocks, or even moving something like a robotic arm. So when we write Python code, we're actually just writing a set of instructions into a file with the .py extension. This file is called a Python script. And ultimately, our objective throughout these tutorials is learning how to write this code so that we can get Python to do useful things for us. For this, you're going to need a code editor. This can be any text editor, but I recommend VS Code. VS Code is simple, it's free, and it's also powerful enough to use professionally. So if you want to get it, then just head over to code.visualstudio.com. And once you're on that page, just follow the instructions for your platform on how to download and install it. After you've installed it, you can open it up. And the first thing you're going to want to do is install the Python extension. So head over to this extensions button on the left here, and then search for Python in the marketplace, and it should be the first result that pops up. So click on that and then click install. I already have it installed, so I'm not going to install it again, but you need this extension if you want to work with Python in VS Code. After you have your extension, then just pick a folder to open up on VS Code or create a new folder for your project. And here we're going to create a new Python file. So head over to this file explorer here at the top, and when you mouse over it, there should be a couple of icons, and one of them is to create a new file. So click that, and here you'll be prompted to enter the name of your file. So let's call this one hello.py. Inside your file, let's write print and then open parentheses and type hello world in quotes. Now you will need to put this hello world text inside quotes. It can be double quotes or single quotes, it doesn't matter, but you have to put it in some kind of quotes for Python to interpret it as a word. Once you've done that, don't forget to save the file. You can do that by hitting Control S on Windows or Command S on a Mac. A common mistake beginners make is to edit the file and then forget to save. That's why VS Code has this little circular indicator on the File tab to indicate when you have unsaved changes in your file. So hit save and that circular tab should be gone. Now you have a Python script. There's actually a couple of different ways you can run it. In VS Code, the easiest way to run your Python script is pressing this little play button in the top right corner here. So if you press that, you're going to see this little window pop up, and then the output of your script should be here. In this case, it says hello world. And this window is actually an inbuilt terminal into VS Code that works just like your other terminal, and then you can even use it to run commands. So we can, instead of pressing this play button to get VS Code to run the script for us, we can just type the command to run the script directly inside this terminal. To do that, you type Python and then the name of your file. So in this case, it's hello.py. And if you type that and hit enter, it runs the script as well. Now, if you've installed multiple versions of Python on your computer, or you've set up multiple different Python environments, you can actually choose which one to use with VS Code by clicking this little button down here that has the version number. And if you click that, it will show you all the different versions of Python that VS Code has detected on your computer, and then you can select that to use that instead. Now, another thing you see quite a lot throughout this tutorial and throughout Python in general are comments. In Python, comments start with this hash symbol. They're not read by the interpreter, and they're used to add notes and explanations to your code. For example, this is a comment right here. You could even try it out yourself if you go back to your Python file, and then at the top of this file, just add a comment, something like say hello, like this. And then if you run it again, you should see that nothing would change. This line is completely ignored. So comments are just a way to leave notes for ourselves or for anyone else that might be reading our code. Throughout this tutorial, I'll be using comments quite a lot, either to explain what's going on with a piece of code or to show you the result of what a line of code will output. So in this case, the top comment describes what we're doing here, that we're adding two numbers together. And the second comment, the #7, shows what the output of this line will be if we actually ran it. So that's all there is to it. You've written and run your first Python program. You've also learned how the interpreter works and how to write comments. Now you're ready to get started learning and using Python. Throughout this tutorial, we're going to be writing a lot more scripts just like this as we learn about major concepts in Python and apply them to build our own Python project in the final part of this series. The project that we're going to be building at the end of the series is going to be a personal budgeting expense tracking app, and it's going to look something like this. So hopefully you'll stick around for that. As a beginner, it's also pretty normal that you're going to get stuck and you're going to have a lot of questions. So here's a few places to get help. First is a GitHub page that I've created specifically for this tutorial series. There you'll find examples of all the code, all the readmes, and an FAQ where if you get stuck or other people get stuck and they have common problems, that's where I'll keep a bunch of the most common questions and answers updated. And if you browse the GitHub repository, you'll be able to find examples of all the code, then you can read them at your own pace. I'll put a link to this GitHub project in the video description. If you're still struggling, you can try searching the internet for answers. A popular website is Stack Overflow, where you'll find answers to most of your questions. But the challenge with searching for answers directly on the internet is that sometimes things can get technical and you might not know what to ask right at the beginning. So if that's you, then I recommend also try out ChatGPT, which is a website from OpenAI. You go there by typing chat.openai.com, and then just type in the question that you have, or even copy paste the code that you want some help with. For example, here, let's ask how to calculate the square root in Python. And if you wait a while, you'll find that it gives you an explanation, code snippets, and generally, this is a pretty good way to get very specific help with a problem you might be having. If you have a line of code that has an error when you try to run it, you can also maybe ask ChatGPT to help you debug that line directly. So remember when I said that we need double quotes to print hello world in Python? Well, here I tried to print it without the quotes and it gave me an error. And ChatGPT will explain to me what the error is and then how to fix it. If you still don't find the answers to your questions, then feel free to head over to the video comments or my YouTube channel page to email me directly. I'll answer them, and I'll also update the FAQ in the project's GitHub page so that other people can benefit from it as well. Otherwise, that's it for this one. See you in the next video, where we'll be learning about variables and data types.